visiting Tank X Capacitor headquarters and factory. I want to see the production line of Tank X. It's very important to see the production. And from the moment these guys are ready to show us the production, it's good, right? So guys, this is the first visit in a Capacitor factory. Everything nowadays, everything uses capacitors, from your mobile phone, power supplies, to your fridge, everything. There's nothing in electronics that doesn't use capacitors.
That's what you need, the size, and then go to here.
Are you making it smaller?
Yeah, make it smaller. Yeah, like this. Every single process we scan, we got a QC code.
So the machine might look old, but they are all connected together. And you can see here on this screen which machine is working and which has stopped working for service, malfunction, etc. And currently, 34 machines are working, 9 machines are not working, and 2 machines are in check mode.
So here you test the foil.
Yeah, the foil. This machine is testing the torrents and the DF, and this one is for the ESR.
For the ESR, okay. Everybody's moving away from the guy, I don't know why.
So
that's the capacitance.
Yeah.
He selects the frequency here. Yeah. 100 Hz here is the most common frequency of this capacitor. ESR. For those who don't know that, equivalent series resistance, ESR. It's a very, very important factor of capacitor.
And how to decide the ESR is depend on the foils, how long.
How long the foil
And the paper.
Yeah, of course, because it has resistance.
Yeah.
And the longer the foil, the
yeah.
More the resistance.
Yeah. So more longer and the low ESR.
So he opened now the foil, and this foil, yeah, has the electrolyte. It's like, yeah, a sponge. So here it's only the foil.
Yeah, only the foil.
No electrolyte.
Yeah. The electrolyte is the next process.
So here is how they test the caps before they go and make a bath in the electrolyte.
He mentioned something that they tested for 8 hours and 20 times.
High voltage.
Yes.
Right now we can see the ESR is like a 1.4. We'll test again and slowly. You gotta scan the QC code. Just like we call the corner, we will put inside. And to
this thing,
the,
you will put it all inside. Huh?
Yeah, put inside and with the electrolyte, like 3 hours go around. Over there, we still have the TV box to control the time.
You have to remove them immediately to go to the next stage.
And here is all got the electrolyte. Always the dry core, and put inside and come out the network. Here is our washing process.
You dry them here?
Yeah, dry them here.
I do this living.
Yeah, for living like this.
Yeah, yeah. Here. Tomato, yeah?
Yeah.
One by one, yeah?
Yeah, one by one.
The aging process. It's crucial for the capacitor to operate
this
properly.
Eight hour testing?
Yeah, after aging, here, come out, we will put 8 hours. After eight hours, and then go to the testing. Yeah.
You do aging voltage treatment.
Actually, here you can see we are already testing the like the LC and the current and the ESR. This is the LC and the current here, and then here is the ESR.
ESR.
Yes, so actually, ESR should be after 8 hours because you came out, it's still hot. Yeah. This temperature for the ESR is one thing. It's really affect the ESR. If go hot. ESR is going low.
If you go cold,
the ESR is so high.
In capacitors, when you hit the capacitor, ESR goes low. This is why when you want to make a failure analysis in a circuit, you will see some old engineers, old school engineers, hit some capacitors, electrolytic ones, to see if the device will start.
Heat.
Because when you keep the capacitor, ESR goes low. The higher the temperature, the lower the ESR. So when they keep the capacitors and specific capacitors and they see that the device starts, they know immediately which capacitor has a problem. What testing does it do?
It's do the like the foil. If the foil has some damage, after engine, it might be fast, it might be not. So here you can see it out.
These are the voltages.
Yeah, voltage, charging voltage.
400 volts.
So yeah, should be 400 and the
lower
testing. Yeah, lower. And the testing voltage.
You can see it's 400 voltage. So, that's the high voltage testing.
If you've got any problem, should be here, it's gotta be out.
These are the new machines. They used to use these machines, but they are phasing them out. They are moving to this. This is furnace.
Yeah.
Do you test 105 degrees or only 85?
It depends on your product.
On the product.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then your voltage. Like 400 voltage usually is 85.
Or 85, yeah.
85.
So you don't do 105. This product.
It's
high end.
It's the current. Your current is, if your current is small. Should be the degrees, should be the higher, like 105.
So guys, the waveform you see here, what do they do to test the capacitors? They apply AC voltage, okay? And they apply AC voltage in steps. They start around 40, 80, okay, then they go up to 450 volt. And AC, when a capacitor gets AC signal, it charges when AC reaches its peak, but when AC decreases, the capacitor starts to release its charge. So
By doing so, the capacitor acts like a temporary storage of voltage. And this is why you see this waveforms here, because they apply the voltage, they raise it. This is a typical behavior of the capacitor when AC voltage is applied. Now, when they increase the voltage more than 330 volts around here, you see, the capacitor starts to decrease its release of energy, of voltage, till it becomes zero. It doesn't release anything here, so it's practically dead. This is something similar that I try to do when I test the capacitors in the lab.
Here is our cutting paper room. The foils always come to here first and then get into the IQC to the test. Yeah, to the test.
The quality.
Like the foils, we are doing tests each, every foils.
So what do they
it's test? The pin. It's the pin. It's the pin. And how pressure you can do it.
Good.
In the aging process.
The aging, yeah.
Yeah, and the testing process.
Yeah, but the aging process gives you a pass or a no pass, a go or no go. We want to make something quantitative, something to measure performance. I take your capacitor, I take a Rubicon, a Temicon.
There's no perfect product. The testing and the aging just control lower quality. You can only compare the material.
Only material.
Yeah.
That's not
because good material, always good. Bad is always bad.
In plain words, I think we have to tell that now. Capacitor stores voltage. It's like a battery. And also capacitor totally blocks DC voltage, but allows AC voltage to pass through. That's to get a very rough idea of what capacitors do. The thing is, in our lab, we apply DC voltage, maximum rating, according to our testing methodology. We increase this voltage after the period of time to higher voltage, high DC voltage, and we mark down the time when the capacitor will collapse, when will it explode. The higher the voltage, the DC voltage capacitor can withstand, it's a factor of its quality. And this is practically one of the very few tests that somebody can do if he doesn't have unlimited electricity and ovens, climate chambers, to put stress to the capacitors. This is the test, blow test.
Yeah, the S-blow test.
This is what I do. The blow-up test. They put the capacitor here, they apply DC voltage till it blows up. Such kinds.
Yeah, huh? Such a carriage.